Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Last session we have seen about email, right? We have seen about email, structure of email, internet threats and all, right? In internet threats we have seen about computer virus, malware, Trojan horse, malicious spyware, computer worm, botnet, spam, phishing, rootkit and all. And then we have seen the familiar internet browsers, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari and all, right? And we have seen about web page and website also. You know what is web page and what is website, right? Website is a collection of web pages, and web page is a single page of a website, right? This website may have several pages, like home page, about us page, contact us page, who we are page and all. That is a collection of web pages, website, right? And a web page means it is a single page in a website, right? Now we are going to see about static and dynamic web pages. Okay, these web pages are classified into two. They are static and dynamic, right? The main difference between this static web page and dynamic web page means static means, you know, it remains the same, but dynamic means it will be changing, right? Here in web page, if a web page is called a static website, means that web page will remain same whenever we are visiting it, right? For example, if you see, we are having a website for our school, right? When you visit that website, it will be same only, since we are doing some updation there, some contents will be added there or some information will be added there. Otherwise, if you are visiting today and tomorrow or next month or next year also, that website will be remaining the same only, right? So that is a static website, right? But here a dynamic website means it is like some displaying marks or some other results and all will be displayed in this dynamic website. That means some site will be there. When you are entering one register number, it will be displaying the marks for that register number, or if you are giving another number, it will be displaying the result for the another number. So that will keep on changing as per the register numbers, right? So these websites are known as dynamic websites, right? This example are websites of government and entrance exam and all are dynamic websites, and small business organizations, school websites, college websites and all will come under static websites, right? Have you got the idea about static and dynamic web pages? Now let's see the comparison between this static web page and dynamic web page, right? The content and layout of a web page will be fixed. If it is a static web page, the content and the layout of that web page will be fixed. It will be like that only, right? But in dynamic web page, the content and layout itself will be changing during the runtime itself. That is dynamic web page, right? In a static web page, that will never use the database. Here in dynamic website, database is used to generate the dynamic content through the queries. That means here in static web page, it will have a content and it will be just displaying that. It won't have a database and all. Here in dynamic web page, it will be working through this database only. When you are giving a question, or when you are giving one number only, it will bring that particular number's result, or when you are giving a question, it will be bringing that product or the answer of that question, right? So this database is used to generate this dynamic content through some questions or through some input, right? That is dynamic web page. Here in static web pages, this directly run on the browser and do not require any server side application program and all. This will directly open in a browser itself, right? Here dynamic web pages runs on the server side application programs, and then only it will display the results. That means here In this dynamic static web page means when you are opening a website, when you are giving the URL for that website, it will automatically open in your browser. If you are using Google or Mozilla or Safari or UC browser, any browser, when you are entering that URL or when you are just clicking that link, it will be opening that website. That is static web page, right? Here dynamic web page means the server side application program will be running, so that when you are giving a query or when you are giving a input, according to that input only it will bring the result for you. So here server side application program will be running, right? This static web pages are easy to develop, but this dynamic web page development requires programming skills. Since this dynamic web page runs on the server side application program, it must be designed in a way that when this input is given, this output or this page must be displayed. Likewise, it must be designed. So this programming skills is necessary to design a dynamic web page. But the static web pages are easy to develop. Just if you know a simple coding, you can just develop a web page, right? Next one is safe surfing on internet. As a great reminder that internet security is something that needs a constant vigilance. That means here internet has everything, right? It has good things, bad things and all. So we have to be sure that whether the website you are visiting is safe or not, right? It's also a great reminder that a lot of things can happen on internet if you don't properly take precautions against them. With that in mind, be sure to have a safe and safer internet day. Right here what they are saying means internet is having so many advantages and also some disadvantages too, right? So when you are visiting a website or when you are browsing something, you must be so keen that whether you are safe in that website, whether that website or whether that link is hacking your computer or your mobile, or whether it is accessing your contacts or whether it is accessing your photos or whether it is getting connected with the details in your mobile or your computer. Likewise, you have to be safe when visiting something in internet. Okay, safer internet day, that is SID, right? This is in 2018, this is celebrated around the world in the year of February, right? In this February every year, Safer Internet Day, that is 2018, this is celebrated all around the world, right? With the theme of create, connect and share respect. That means a better internet starts with you, like that. Create, connect and share respect, right? Here the some of the do's and don'ts of the safe surfing on internet they have given. Let's see that. Don't give your personal information. Okay, don't give out your personal information. Don't put personal details such as your home address, telephone numbers or your parents' work address online. Why they are saying that you should not give these details means some cyber criminals can use this information to create a fake profile with your details, right? If you have used Facebook or Instagram, you would have seen this. Someone will be having their personal account and they'll be displaying all their address, all their location of working, everything. So someone else also can create an account in their name, and they can, if they are updating that, the people or the friends will get confused which is the fake account, right? So you have to be sure that those details, your address, your phone number, these details are private to you. You should not give them public, right? If it is private, you will be accepting your friends, whoever you know, right? So there will be no issues, right? That is the first, don't give out your personal information. Okay, what goes online stays online. Use privacy settings to make sure only your friends and family can see photos you post. Avoid posting holiday plans, as criminals have been known to track your movements. Right here, what goes online stays online. That means if you are posting something online, public, in public means whoever needs, they can see, right? And not everyone is good, right? Someone will be staying out there to track you. So if you are giving out your holiday plans, or if you are giving your location and your family, you are giving your address, everything online means if some criminals may be tracking your movements, they can they'll be just seeing your social websites itself, and they can follow you, right? So it is not safe to give. So you can just set your privacy to your friends only, or your family, or you can just make it private, right? So that only your circle will be knowing your holiday trips or your location or everything, right? These things should not be public, right? Until and unless if you are going somewhere and posting that particular thing in a social networking site, means if you are giving it public, you must be sure that you are not going to lose anything from that, right? If you are just closing your home, and if you are shifting to some other place, and if you are putting that online, means someone will be knowing that your home is closed and no one is there, right? So you must be clear that whatever details you are giving online is safe and secure for you, right? And the next one is check your security and privacy settings. You have to make sure your social network privacy settings are secured, so only your friends can see your personal information, and use your privacy settings to restrict who can see your post, videos and photos. If you are just posting your old photos in that, in if you have taken in some place, and if you are posting it, that old photos at with the location, means it's not a big deal, right? If you are posting something publicly, and if you are setting your privacy as public, and if you are posting, updating everything there, means it is not good, right? First, you have to check your security and privacy settings of the social network, right? That means you have to be secured whether the details you are sharing can be public, or with whether this must be seen only with your family and friends. Means you have to set the privacy in such a way, and then only how to post any story or any videos or photos, right? Next one is password safety. That is, sharing your password with your parents is a sensible idea, but avoid sharing your password with your friends, right? Even if they promise they won't tell anyone, also when setting your password, make sure it is not something people may guess, such as it should not be your name or your pet's name, or it should not be your name and date of birth, or your name and mobile number. Like that, it should not be a easy one to guess, right? Use a mixture of letters, numbers. It must can have uppercase, lowercase, or it can have some symbols in between also, right? So this password safety, that means you can trust your parents, and you can give your password to your mother and father, but you can trust your friends, that's not a big deal. But when you are giving your password to your friend, your friend may be loyal, and he or she will be keeping your password safely only. But if they are entering that password in their mobile or in some other computer, means if someone else is using that mobile or computer, means they may feel one password is there, so we can enter into the account and we can just see the details. That is not good, right? So never give your passwords to your friend. Even if your friend has created your account also, it is better if it is your private account, or if you are sharing your details, and if you are giving your photos, and if you are using that account as a private, your account, your personal account, means you should change the password once you start using it, right? If your friend has created it, and if your friend has given the password, that's not an issue. Once you get it and once you start to use it as a personal account, you must change the account and you must keep that account personally for you and only you and maybe your parents, your mother and father may know your password. That's enough, right? And the next one is always protect your mobile device. That means you have to make sure your mobile phone is pin protected so that if you are having your mobile phone in your hand and you don't have any important things in your mobile also, it must be password protected, because if you leave your mobile in some place or if you are going in a crowd and if your mobile is lost, their contacts is also there. Contact will be there and your banking messages will be there. With that also, if someone get your mobile without password, if they are just opening the messages itself, they'll get your banking details. Banking details will be coming to your mobile through SMS, right? So that is not safe to use a mobile without password, right? Make sure your mobile phone is pin protected so all your information and your personal information is stored on it and it is safe, okay? If you want, you can download a security app which allows you to remotely wipe any personal data. Your mobile when your mobile is lost or stolen, right? Here in Apple devices and all, if you see, you'll be able to track the device when it is lost, right? How this is done, you'll be connecting it with your family members or your friend's phone. That means you are not sharing your data with your friends. Here in Apple, if you see, it is giving some built-in apps itself, like Find Friends and all. If you have once connected your device with another friend or another one Apple device, if your mobile is lost also in that friend or in that person's device, you can just see where your mobile, the location and where your mobile is moving, what is done in your mobile, these all the things you can just view it in your friend's mobile which you have connected once, right? And next one, if you are using Android, means Android also you are having many security apps. If you want, you can just download it and keep. But that security apps also, you must be sure whether it is a verified app, right? Once if you download that app, if someone else is getting your mobile or if it is stolen or if you have lost it, you can just delete all the details in it. Like that also options is there, right? You will be having a separate ID and password for in that device. And you can enter that ID and password in some other device and you can delete the things which is in your mobile also, right? It may happen. We don't know when we'll lose our mobile or when it will be stolen, right? Sometimes if it happens, you must be secure, right? Or if your SIM is there, you may go to the SIM network and you may block it. But before blocking it itself, till that time also, that messages and all will be there, right? Banking messages will be there. Some banking details will be linked with your payment apps and all. So if you are having Android or a smartphone or an Apple device, it must be password protected. And even if you are not saving any of your personal or account details also, it must be password protected only, right? Then don't talk to strangers online or offline. Don't meet up with strangers and let your parents know if a stranger has tried to get in contact with you online. See, we will be using Facebook or Instagram or WhatsApp or maybe a wrong call, anything. You will be hearing someone's voice. It may be a boy or a girl. It's not an issue, but whoever is talking, you should not believe them, right? Until if it is your friend or if it is your family member or if you have seen them directly and if you are talking to someone you know, that's not an issue. But if you are talking through an account, to an account, even some accounts may look as a genuine account, but it will be a fake ID. You cannot
identify whether it is fake account also, right? When you start to talk, or if you are getting messages from a stranger also, you will be thinking that here a photo is there and the details are there, so he or she is a genuine guy, so you can just talk to them, that's not an issue, like that you will think. But not everyone is genuine, right? If you are having an account, someone may create an account in your name and they can take your photos and they can upload it, and that is a fake account, but it will look like your account, right? So this may happen and you may get fooled, right? So the better way is you should never talk to a stranger online. That this is the big issue in being online, right? If you know someone, if it is your friend or classmate, that's not an issue. If you are just seeing the name and photo and talking, means it won't be, it's not good, right? Sometimes they may be talking to you and they may become your friends, and you too may talk and you can become their friends. But later on, it may get to you so many troubles, right? Troubles means you can say, I'm not sharing my details, I'm not sharing my mobile number, or I'm not sharing my photo, I'm not sharing anything, I'm just talking. Why? What issue will be there in talking? Likewise, you may think. But sometimes if they are hacker, they can you'll be just chatting with them. If they are sending a small link, they'll be sharing a video, or they'll be saying that they'll share their photo, or they'll share some app or some link. Just a link is enough. If you are just clicking the link, what will happen means the data, the whole data inside your mobile will be sent to that person who sent you the link, right? Likewise, also so many hacking techniques are also there. So you should never talk to a stranger, either it is online or offline, right? Because hackers can create apps that will get all the data from the mobile, right? They'll just send a link in the chat itself. They can just send a link. When you just see that link, when you just open that link itself, all your data from the mobile, maybe your photos, contacts, your banking details, your messages, your call list, your WhatsApp chats, everything they can see, right? Like this also, so many issues are there, and they have been reported to cyber crime also. So be careful in chatting online, right? Next one is, listen to the adults you know. Adults will always be worried about you. Help set their mind at rest and avoid chatting online with strangers. This is also the same point. If you are having if you have got a message from a stranger, or if you are getting a message from a stranger and you started to talk, but you don't know whether that is a genuine account, that is a genuine guy, they may send photos also. Fake accounts will be acting as so good than the genuine accounts, right? They'll be having the mobile number, they'll be giving the photos, everything, and they'll be acting as the whole as a genuine account, right? So if you have started to talk to a stranger also, you just say about them in your family, and then you won't be getting into trouble, right? If something happens, if your data may be stolen, or sometimes if you are just clicking some link, it may erase all your mobile data also. Like that also, some hackers are there. They'll be just giving your link. If you are just clicking that, all the data in your mobile will be erased, and they'll be able to operate your mobile. Then what will happen? You will be having a Facebook or Instagram account. They'll be operating your account. From your account, they'll be sending the message to someone else, right? So like this, so many issues are there. So once if you have unknowingly started to talk to a stranger also, you must inform it to your sister, brother, or your relatives, or your mother, father, anyone. You have to just share it to them and don't get into trouble. Okay, the best way is don't talk to strangers online or offline. Okay, be wary of unsecured or unknown websites. When shopping online, Use reputable and known retailers. Right now, you know what are the shopping websites available, and so many, many, many shopping websites are there. Some fake websites are also there. You will be just seeing a product and going inside. You will have never had that name itself, but that shopping website will be there. You will be doing the payment, and then you won't be receiving your product. That means it's a fake account, right? After that, when you are just sending a query or when you are whatever you do, they won't be responding. They'll be just blocking you. Like that also, some shopping websites are there. So before doing online shopping, you must check. We know some genuine websites, right? Before buying a product, you must check the reviews there. You must check the reviews. You must check for the genuineness of that shopping website, right? And then only you must do the shopping, right? Here, if you see, now you know Amazon, Flipkart, you know what are the good websites, right? Before installing a shopping website app itself, you can see the review there, and if it is fake or if there is some problem, if I have ordered something, customized something and ordered, when I just install that app itself, many people has commented that I had ordered a product but I didn't receive it. I have ordered a product, they are not responding me. I have done the payment but they are not giving the products. Like that itself, the review is there. So once I see that option under that app, the reviews are there. When I read that review itself, I didn't install that app, right? And you can just verify it in Google itself, right? Before doing the online shopping, you just check whether they are a verified shopping website or not. Okay, here it will be Amazon, means AMAZON. If like that the main app is there, some apps may be there, it may look like Amazon but the spelling will be different or the logo will be little different. So you have to check it before buying any products, right? Some brands also, it may look like a branded one but the brand name or the spelling or the logo will have a slight change, right? That may be a duplicate product, right? You will be thinking that this brand product is so damn cheap, like that you'll be thinking, but the thing is that that will be the duplicate brand, right? The next one is, be careful what links you click on. Avoid clicking links in an email, instant message or on your social network unless you are sure the message is from someone you know. Right here they have given that be careful what links you click on. Even if you are here, they have given that if you know someone, you can just click that link. They have like that, they have given. But I am saying you that you should never click on a link unnecessarily, right? Because if someone has hacked your friend's account, and from your friend's account also you can get a link which hacks your mobile, right? Once you get a link, you have to check that link. You have to check that link if it is sent from your school or if it is sent from your official, from any official website to give a review or to give a exam, means that is okay. But if you are getting a link unnecessarily in WhatsApp and all, if you see, so you just click on this link, you will win 1,000 rupees, you will win 10,000 rupees, or click on this link to win a Apple iPhone, like that and all, they'll be attracting you. Once you click on that link, your mobile will be under someone else's control, right? Like that, if one person is being caught itself, their mobile will be under that hacker, right? So that hacker, what that hacker will do, that hacker will send the link to all his contacts. So once, if your friend's mobile is hacked also, you will get the link from your friend's account only. But that account will be hacked and someone else will be using that, right? So like that also, many issues are there. So you must be careful before clicking any link, right? If it is a exam, you will get a genuine link from your genuine school or if from your teacher, right? If it is for reviewing something or if it is for your project purpose, you will get the link in a genuine way from the genuine person, right? You have to, if you are getting a link also, you can again check it. You can ask whether this is a genuine link, can I open it, whether it is secure. And when you are opening itself, it will ask. If it is for an exam, it will just give you the questions, right? Or if it is a If some link will be there, it will show you when you are clicking the link, it will ask you, allow photos, allow your contacts to access, allow, when you are downloading some app also, it may ask, allow contacts, allow photos, allow your phone details will be shared. You won't be reading that, you will be just giving allow, 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 everything allow, and then only the app will be installed. You have to read everything and then only you have to accept it. Okay, when you are creating an account also, some apps and all will be saying you that we'll be using all your details. We'll be taking all your images, contacts, everything to into our account. Some genuine apps will be there. They'll be saying you that we won't be, we'll be just taking it for our use. We won't be sharing it to anyone. Like that it will be given. Some apps will be taking it and it will be set to public. So you have to check it, right? Now that we have come to the end of this chapter, so the next chapter will be about creating a web page using the HTML tags, right? So here we have seen about web page, websites and all, right? And about internet surfing, what is, how you can browse internet safely, and we have seen about browsers and all in this chapter. In the next chapter, we'll be knowing how to create a web page. I told you, web static web pages are easy to develop, right? If you are learning HTML, you can itself develop a web page, right? So in the next chapter, we'll be able to develop a web page using HTML tags. Okay, thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.